to be my new style. Good morning, guys. This is Flint from Circle G Kiko. It is a beautiful 27 degree morning. So yesterday we went to Fayetteville, Arkansas, little road trip. Vanna and myself have been following a channel on YouTube. Her name is Claire, and she has milk goats. She has Nubian, Nigerian dwarfs, and her one of her Nigerians had babies. So Vanna contacted her immediately and said, "Hey, I would be interested in one of your bucklings if you're going to be selling them." And so they kind of talked back and forth. Savannah ended up picking one of the three bucklings. So yesterday we made a 6-hour road trip through blizzards. The wind was blowing like, I think my phone said 34 mile an hour wind gust. It was awful, but we made the 6-hour round trip, picked up this little buckling. He's a cute little booger. Savannah has named him Elvis, and he's a fully registered Nigerian dwarf buck. I'll take you guys out and show you him in a minute, but first, I would like you guys to go check out her channel at C&J Funny Farms. She does all kinds of stuff with goats. She's got coonie pigs. Go over there to their channel at C&J Funny Farms. Give them a follow. If you like these girls, you'll probably like hers too. So go check them out. Give them a follow. Share the love. And take you out here and show you Elvis. Hey girls and boys. Hi girls and boys. Zorro. Good morning, Zorro. Good morning. Milky Way, did you have babies last night? Oh look, no babies. Oh look, no babies. When are you gonna have babies? Keep checking her. Just keep on checking her. All right guys, here's Elvis. This is Elvis. Hi buddy. Hi, buddy. Hi. He's like, "What's going on? Come here, buddy. Come here." All right, guys, this is Elvis. He's a cutie. You're a cutie, aren't you? Yeah, you are. That's your girlfriend over there in the other stall. Yeah. Your girlfriend over there talking to you. I'm gonna let you out with the rest of the herd here. If I can. I got two goats up on the door. I can't get out. I can't get out. Get off the door. Okay. Back out. Okay. All right, buddy. There you go. You got a lot to check out. They're a wee bit bigger than you, buddy. Especially Prince there. He's way bigger than you are. Lola's way, way, way bigger than you are. Everybody's gonna have to check him out. Hi, Zorro. Good morning. It'll take him just a little while to get used to everybody. Everybody's going to have to sniff him and check him out. Somebody new. Whoa. Let's not be mean. You are a wee bit bigger than he is. Feel like once we open up the hot fence, I get it all fixed back up. Feel like he could walk right out from underneath the wire. He'll probably be out in the yard. Be out in the yard eating. Everybody's just checking him out. They gotta do their butting around and stupid crap they always do. Zorro seems to like him. Well, I'll have to keep an eye on him. quite a while. Make sure nobody's being mean to him. Kind of popping him a little bit. They're not hurting him or nothing. They're just letting him know that they're the bosses, I guess. I don't know. I keep an eye on him, make sure that nobody's gonna hurt him or nothing. Go ahead and get him some feed and get their mind off of him. Give it a day and they won't even notice he's in there. Zorro seems to like him. Shoot, he's already part of the herd. He's already hanging out with him. Come on, come on, come on. Zorro really likes him. They might be buddies. Pain right now is, hey, Pain is I gotta keep the llamas and the goats separate. Cause right now we're feeding medicated feed that the llamas can't have. So I gotta try to sort them off like a pain in the butt. Watch out guys, watch out. Here guys, come on. Here. Little dude must have went back around the barn. Okay. Ah, we'll feed the llamas. I'm gonna put Milky Way back in with the other girls. And then, might work on the barn today. I'm not sure yet. Need to work on the barn today. But it is cold. At least the wind's not blowing. Hey, little dude. You should have went in there with the goats. Alright, go get some food and feed the llamas. Okay, llamas are fed, but Zorro's more concerned about little dude over there than eating his feed, so go get Milky Way out. Go get Milky Way out of her pen. Zorro, come over here and eat your feed. Breakfast time. Come on now. Yeah. Booger, go eat. Lola's eating. See, it's kind of a pain. I have to keep them and the goats separated because that medicated feed, whatever they use for the medication part, not good for llamas. So we cannot, I can't have them in there eating that. I've got to let the goats eat and then I've got to go dump the tubs out when they're done. The llamas can't get any of it. That's just pain. Maybe we'll do something different eventually. I'm trying to get you. Out. There you go. Come on. Yeah, you go. Oh. She's like, what is this thing? I need to get the bucket out of here. Purple bucket. Darn it, Milky Way. You can't go eat their feet. Milky Way. Go. Out the gate. Out the gate. Come on. Out the gate. Thank you. Come on, Milky Way. Oh, Lordy. Put her head through the fence to eat. You can't catch a break. Come on. Come on. He ain't had no baby yet. That's the one we went and got yesterday. Get in there. The feed's not there, she's already. What are you doing? Oh, bring a new four-wheeler? Or your old four-wheeler? No, it's not. Alright, girls. Alright. Watch out. There you go. There you go, Milky Way. Come on. Now you can have some feed. It's like their hay feeders empty, so I have to get some feed. Feed Remy. Check the cats. I guess I'll go get a bale of alfalfa for these girls. Well, the girls got hay now, so they're happy. They go through alfalfa like candy. Don't ya? Always gotta put your feet in it. Goats always got to have their feet in their feed. They can't just eat it without trying to put their feet in. Kai's to buy him a new four-wheeler. He's playing with it. Alright, I need to get motivated to start on the building project or fence project or something. I got something done today. Just gotta decide what. I think I need to work on the barn, but I also gotta get hot fence done too. I think I'll go work on the barn for a little bit. Like these guys are done eating, so I guess I'll go ahead and dump the tubs out. Make sure there ain't no feed left in them, and then let the llamas back in. Ain't no feed left in there. You guys are doing a good job cleaning up. Okay. Yeah, they eat every bit of it this morning. All right, little dude. Yeah, I know. Yeah, I hear where I can keep an eye on him, make sure nobody's being mean to him. He's over there with the llamas. Lola's watching him. Lola's watching. All right, I'll go over here and try to do something with the new barn. All right, guys, can you see? All my posts are set up now. I'm thinking this morning I'm going to take all the screws that I got around the bases, take them all loose, and then start getting this thing raised up to 8 feet in the front and figuring out what I want in the back. And then I'll cut, if there's any posts sticking out, I'll cut the tops off of them. I'll have to go get a ladder, I guess. And then, yeah, just start getting this building framed in. I got a screw in each corner, so I'm raising it up about, I don't know, I'm gonna get about 8 inches out of it. I set my two screws and go to the other side, back the screws out, raise another 8 inches, put the screws back in, just go back and forth. I'll just stair step it up so I get to my height. little tricks you learn while working by yourself, especially when you're framing stuff. Screws can be your best friend. Just like this. I don't have anybody here to help me. Got a 20-foot board. I can't hold this end up and that end up at the same time. Now I could kind of pick this end up and screw it and then go down there and set that in, or then I'd end up having to cut two ends, or I wouldn't have a straight edge because, well, I'm trying to do a two-man job with one guy. But so I want to be a foot off the ground is where I want it. So I put a screw right here. Now I'm gonna take this board, set it up on that screw. Now I can go down there and work at that end. That screw will hold that up for me. I can slide it back and forth and do whatever I want. This end's already set to height. I'll get that end set, put a level on it, get that end screwed up, come down here and screw this in. We're done. Side, there's 2 inches of slope, so I'm gonna have to add some dirt. Guys, got my boards all the way around. Everything's level. Now, thinking about put it in my drawing, you know, the one on the paper towel at work. I'm putting a 2x6 on edge on these two center legs and butt them up against the rafter. One on either side, and then I'll toenail screw into the rafter where they're supposed to be. And that'll help keep everything out, help with load bearing weight from the roof. And then like when my big butt's up there walking around screwing it, and snow and just making everything stay square and neat and pretty. But I think it'll keep the roof from sagging over time. I even thought about, I bought two to even possibly do the same on these ends. Put them up against and butt them up against to help hold the rafter. I don't know. That might just be overkill, but I don't know. It's coming along. It actually looks like a building somewhat now. Other than chopping off the tops of the posts. There's a few of them that are sticking up more than others, but other than chopping off top of the post, I think that's pretty well it. Other than I need to get some, either I'm gonna get some paint or I'm gonna get some Thompson's water seal or something and paint this front board. These ends that I cut off, all these ends I wanna paint. I'd like to cover this bottom board because that's going to be the one that's more exposed to weather, and like these ends up here that are cut off, it will soak up moisture. I'd like to get them sealed anywhere that I wished I would have had some treated, but oh well, not that big a deal. Once I get metal on it, it's not going to get tons of exposure. As far as the building goes, until I get them boards sealed, I can't put metal on. I could, but I'm not going to. I'll regret it down the road if I do, so I'll go ahead and wait till I can get some sealer put on them, and then I'll probably wait till the wind's not blowing. I say that, and I'll wait till a really windy day. I'll get in the mood and get out here and fight metal and wind. Wind's starting to kind of pick up, so I think I'm going to pick up tools. Maybe go work on some hot fence or something, but as far as the building goes, it's up, looks good, pretty good size structure. I'm pretty happy with it. I think it'll make one heck of a barn. Anyway, guys, unless I do something else, it's gonna be it for today. Like always, God bless you from Circle G Kiko. Thanks for watching.